Hello everyone, this is Grace and I am back here again with another video. And now today the video is regarding the data science, and I am sure that this is starting regarding the data science because I am doing my specialization in the data science, so we'll be meeting frequently regarding this data science. Now let's get started. Regarding data science, the topics which we are going to discuss today are data reduction and correlation analysis. First of all, let's get started with the data reduction. Data reduction means, in simple words, we can say that we are reducing the data using different techniques. And after reducing the data, we'll be getting some simplified data set. And during the data reduction process, we mainly focuses on variables or constructs which are most likely to carry meaning and least likely to carry noise. And these are some of the definitions which can help us to understand regarding the data reduction. And coming to the purpose of the data reduction, we can say that it reduces the number of data records by eliminating invalid or unimportant data, and also it produces summary of data and statistics at different aggregation for various applications. And we are having again three methods in the data reduction. Those are dimensional data reduction, numerosity reduction, and data compression. Coming to dimensional data reduction, dimensional data reduction means it helps us to reduce noise in the data and also allows us to do visualization easily. For example, we are transforming the three-dimensional data into two-dimensional data to show hidden parts using dimensional data reduction. And whenever we came across any data which is less important, then we'll be using some attributes which is required for our analysis. And it reduces by eliminating outdated or redundant features. And we are again having three methods in the dimensional data reduction. Those are stepwise forward selection, stepwise backward elimination, and decision tree induction. Coming to stepwise forward selection, this selection will be begins with empty set, and we'll be adding the elements or attributes which are best in the given set. So here the given set is A, B, C, D, E, and F, and we are taking an initial set as an empty set, and we are checking which attribute is the best one. So we found that C is the best one, so we added C to the empty set, and again we found that E is the best one, so we have added, and finally by adding all the best elements or the best attributes in the given set, we got C, E, and B in the final reduced set. And the places or the order of the elements in the set can be based on the relevance of attributes with each other. So this is the stepwise forward selection, and stepwise backward reduction is the same as the stepwise forward the first process. So here the selection starts with a set of complete attributes. Here you can see that we started with initial reduced set as full set like A, B, C, D, E, and F, and we are eliminating the less important or least important attribute from the set. So here we removed F. Here we removed F from the given set, and again we removed D. So finally, after removing all the least and unimportant attributes, we got with C, E, and B. And we are the third one we are having is decision tree reduction. In the decision tree reduction, this is a very complete full theory, but just for now we are having a small glimpse in it. So this C is the root node, like we got with C, E, B as the best elements. So C can be placed as the root node, E and B, like if yes it is B, if no it is E. And these C1, C2, C3 and C4 are the labels which we got from the calculation or from these root nodes. So this is the decision tree reduction. And also we can have combination of forwarding and backward selection, which helps us to remove the worst and which helps us to select the best attributes by saving time and making the process faster. And that concludes the dimensional data reduction. Now we are coming to numerosity reduction. Numerosity reduction means here we are not having actual data. We are replacing the actual data with some mathematical models or smaller representation of data. So in here we are again having parametric and non-parametric methods. In the parametric we are having a regression and log linear model. In the regression we are having again simple linear regression and multiple linear regression. In the simple linear regression we can actually say simply like y equal to x plus b. Like all the data can be placed in a straight line. Here I mentioned that to fit in a straight line, like if we use this statement or if we use this expression, the data can be fit into a straight line, completely into a straight line. And we are also having multiple linear regression. Here only we are having one predictor variable in simple linear regression, whereas in multiple linear regression we are having two or more predictor variables. And coming to the log linear model, a log linear model can be used to estimate. Mostly it is used to estimate the probability of each data, and multidimensional space, and it is based on a smaller subset of dimensional combination. So this allows us higher dimensional data space to be constructed from lower dimensional attributes by using an expression called log y equal to ax plus b. And coming to the non-parametric methods, we are again having four methods in the non-parametric methods. Those are histograms, clustering, sampling, and data cube aggregation. Coming to histograms, we are all well known with histograms. Histograms means it is a graph which is used in terms of the frequency, and it uses binning to approximate data distribution, and it is a popular form of data reduction. Here you can see this picture explains us what is histogram. Here we have an example like that. And coming to the clustering means dividing the data into groups or clusters. It is called the clustering. So this technique mainly partitions the whole data into different clusters. Like here you can see here in this example, here blue, red, and yellow. These are different clusters or different groups we have formed from the given data. And here you can observe that there are some attributes or some elements outside the groups. So these are also called as outliers. So this is just an example for clustering. And regarding sampling means it is also used in the data reduction, because it allows a large data set to be represented as a smaller random data sample or a subset. And data cube aggregation means it involves moving the data from detail level to a fewer number of dimensions. So, and the third one is data compression. Data compression means simply it uses some encoding mechanisms. Like encoding mechanisms means we can say that Huffman encoding and run length encoding. And it compresses the data using those encoding mechanisms. So we are again having here lossless compression and lossy compression. Lossless compression means we didn't lose any data, or we didn't lose the original data by this technique. But here lossy compression means we'll be losing the original data, and the original data will be different from the data which we got after this technique. So this is the data compression. And now with this we have completed regarding the data reduction. Like, we are having three methods: numerosity reduction, dimensional reduction, and data compression. And we also seen that what are the different methods aggregated in those main three methods. And now we are entering into correlation analysis. So correlation analysis means, the definition for the correlation analysis is that it is one of the statistical technique to determine the dependence between two or more variable. In other words, we can say that correlation is a statistical technique that can show whether and how strongly pairs of variables are related. So it mainly focuses on the relation between the variables. So, and here we are having some correlation coefficients like Pearson coefficient, Spearman coefficient, and Kendall's coefficient, and also point Becerral coefficient, etc. We are having so many correlation coefficients, and we are going to see soon. And the common formula which we use for correlation is the ratio of covariance of two variables to the product of the standard deviations. Here you can see that the ratio of covariance of two variables x and y with the standard deviation of their product of their standard deviations. This is the formula. And regarding the correlation analysis, we have some interpretation. With the results, we have some interpretation. Like, correlation coefficient, mainly it varies between minus 1 and plus 1. So correlation, it is symbolized by R. And also, if the correlation is between plus 1 and minus 1, it is a linear dependence. And if it is exactly 1, then it can be called as perfect positive linear correlation. And if it is exactly minus 1, then it is called as perfect negative linear correlation. And if it is 0, there is no correlation. And if it is between 0 and 1, then it is positive linear correlation. And if it is between minus 1 to 0, then it will be negative linear correlation. So finally, the purpose of the correlation is we can say is that to determine the extent to which two variables vary together. Like in the first only I mentioned that correlation gives the relation between two variables. So the purpose is that to determine the extent, and also to determine the strength and direction of the relationship. and the fields which correlation can be applied are scientific data analysis, marketing research, and business analysis, and does not indicate, like, correlation does not indicate one variable could be used to predict the other variable. So we cannot predict the other variable using one variable, and also one variable doesn't causes the other variable. So this cannot be indicated, and these are the applied fields, and these are the purposes for using correlation analysis. And now we are going to see some practical explanation regarding correlation analysis. Here you can see that actually already I explained regarding the negative correlation and complete correlation and positive correlation, and this is the formula. Yeah, here we have imported some libraries like NumPy, SciPy, and Pandas, Seaborn. We have imported some libraries, and we have a data called wine.csv. It is a file, and we imported that, we read that file into DFG. So this is the file, this is the data, and here the important thing is we are calculating correlation between two columns like QA and OD280. These are the two columns in the data, so we are calculating correlation between these two columns using NumPy library, and this is using SciPy library. And here we got the result as 1 means the correlation between itself is obviously 1, so it is 1, and this is the correlation between those two variables. And here we have plotted some scatter plots so that we can understand how those variables are related. If we plot a straight line, we'll be getting some positive correlation here. And finally, like, simply we can calculate correlation using this method, like CORR. This is a method, so simply we can calculate correlation using this statement. Here we can see that the correlation between both alcohol and alcohol, those are the same, no? So we are getting 1, and the correlation between malic acid and malic acid will be 1, and the correlation between ash and alcohol, you can see that it is 0.21145. So like that, we'll be getting a correlation between among the all columns, among all the variables, by using this statement. And correlation analysis examines the linear relationship, like I already mentioned. It examines the linear relationships of the variables. And again, I have used another different data set, like I have used Boston and performed the same, performed the same correlation again here. And again, you can see here, this is the correlation method which I have used to find the correlation between among the variables. And here I have plotted some heat map so that we can understand clearly. You can see this here, all the ones in this diagonally, you can see that the correlation between among them, like same variable, will be obviously 1, and these the outside here, you can see that these are all the correlation variables. So with this, I'm concluding my vlog. I hope you found it informative. Yeah, that's the end of this video. So I hope you liked it and you find it informative.